Meanwhile, questions remain after members of Michigan's football team anonymously alleged in a Detroit Free Press report that the team often violated NCAA limits on off-season practices. Questions the university says it will seek answers to via internal investigation. Meanwhile, newly embattled Wolverines coach Rich Rodriguez had this to say: "We know the practice and off-season rules, and we stay within the guidelines. We follow the rules and have always been completely committed to being compliant with all NCAA rules." And this from Michigan AD Bill Martin in part, and I quote, "We are committed to following both the letter and the intent of the NCAA rules, and we take any allegations of violations seriously. We believe we have been compliant with NCAA rules, but nonetheless, we have launched a full investigation of the allegations. In today's newspaper, we have already reached out to both the Big Ten and the NCAA, and we will have more to say on this as soon as we have completed our assessments." For more, we are now joined by our college football reporter, Joe Shad. He is live there in Ann Arbor. And Joe, you in fact spoke with two former Wolverine players and one current Michigan player about these allegations. What did you take away from those conversations?
Well, Josh, obviously there are a lot of anonymous sources in this reporting, but one guy who is finally willing to go on the record is former Michigan wide receiver Tony Clemens, who is now at Colorado. Clemens told me that there are, quote, no exaggerations, no fabrications to the original report. Clemens told me that he is looking forward to telling the NCAA the truth about how many hours he put in when he was at Michigan, including what he said were 12-hour days on Sundays between practice and training. And so he said that he wants to stick out for and look out for his former teammates back here in Michigan.
Could be quite the fallout then from these allegations. First to the school, Bill Martin, again, Michigan's AD, says that he has launched an investigation. Presumably the NCAA will also get involved here. If violations are found, what could be the penalty faced?
Well, Josh, based on precedent here, it is certainly a possibility that if the allegations are found to be true, that Michigan could lose scholarships, they could have future practice time taken away, and they could also conceivably go on probation. It's important to note that I've learned that yesterday, Big Ten compliance officials arrived here in Michigan, and with Michigan compliance officials, Josh, they have begun to interview Michigan players and officials about exactly how many hours these kids have been putting in.
It has been a very tenuous day for Rich Rodriguez thus far there in Ann Arbor. It was a pitiful season a year ago, and now this. How could it all affect the coach's stature, really, with the school and its alumni?
Well, Josh, there's no doubt that all Michigan football fans are disappointed and angry about the way last season went. And so allegations such as this will certainly do nothing other than add to the pressure that Rodriguez faces to have success in this season. Here in Ann Arbor, there are many Lloyd Carr loyalists, many people who don't necessarily approve of the fact that Rich Rodriguez is not a, quote, Michigan man. And so there's no doubt that this just turns up the fire on a coach who's trying to win the approval of a community here at Michigan.